There's King of the Pit TV live and large, you know who it is by now. This one's entitled Without a Face. Rage Against the Machine, we're listening to the whole record Evil Empire, let's go. Shout out to YouTube for unblocking my Rammstein videos. There are a few Rammstein videos and they got copyright claim to hell and back. Couldn't use them whatsoever, but yeah, one thumbs up to you, YouTube. Thanks. Where are we going? When he wants to, he can always throw a good hook in there. Uses the song title, rinses and repeats, repetition, hypnotizes. That statement into your head, really good. Feels like the bassist is hitting two notes there. Boom, 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 boom. I don't like it. I wish he went to a different note because I'd be grooving on that bass line right now, but it's just that one note that puts me off. Cool, it wasn't their best tune. Evil Empire, is this Rage Against the Machine's first album? Let me just check that out, because I assumed it was, disregarding like any sort of demos that came out beforehand. Rage Against the Machine, discography, okie dokie, one moment. Wow, wait, no way. No way. Did the self-title come out before this? Right, so is this the second record? They only had four studio records, apparently. That's crazy. To say the degree of success they had. And I think Renegades was essentially like a cover record, wasn't it? Okay, so this was the second record. I didn't know that. The self-titled, obviously, was the first. Next, we've got Wind Below. And I say that because, you know what? Given Rager the scale they are, I don't think some of these tunes, at least as far as the songwriting go, don't get me wrong, I'm not talking lyric here or concept. As far as the sound goes of the actual song and that, there is quite a broad spectrum of what I like and what I think is a bit, boring, let's be fair. I didn't think too much to that tune. We got Wind Below next. And I'll catch you in one moment.